Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. Today we will be moving the simple cube along the x-axis and tweening its motion. I will be using DOTween, to which you'll find a link in the description. It's available for free on the Asset Store, so start off by installing it if you haven't already. I'll start off by creating a script called move and attaching it to my cube. In the top here, let's type using dg.tweening. I'll just quickly clean this up and remove the update method. Since the script is attached to the cube, we can type transform.doMove, which will modify the transform of the object the script is attached to. You should now get a list of available methods related to movement. I'll just pick doMoveX, since I'll only be moving the cube on the x-axis. The first parameter is the position to where we want to move on the x-axis, and is of type float and not a vector3, since we're only moving on the x-axis. The second parameter is the duration, how long we want the movement to take. This will move our cube to 5 on the x-axis in 2 seconds and stop at that position. We can now make the cube move back and forth by setting it to loop. We're using set loops, where the first parameter is how many times we want it to loop. Setting the value to -1 will make the cube loop forever. Here you can also set the loop type, we'll just set it to yo-yo. Let's have a look. This feels a bit too snappy for me, but we can override the easing to make the movement a bit more smooth. And this is where set ease comes to play. Start by typing ease and you'll be presented with plenty of options. I will use in-out sine, which will add a sine wave motion to both the start and the end of the movement. Let's have a look at what this looks like now. This is much better in my opinion. Start playing around with this to get a result you like. You might also end up using doMove. This works essentially the same, but instead of a float value, it takes a vector3. Another thing to keep in mind is that the movement occurs in world space. Should you want to move in local space, you can just use doLocalMove instead. And the script is, of course, available on my GitHub page. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.